बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। आई एम डॉक्टर मोहम्मद लतीफ, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर ऑफ मेडिसिन फ्रॉम अख्तर सईद ट्रस्ट हॉस्पिटल। टुडे आई विल बी डिलीवरिंग अ लेक्चर टू फोर्थ ईयर क्लास MBBS एंड टुडेज लेक्चर विल बी ऑन मैक्रोसाइटिक एनीमिया, लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। At the end of the lecture, when you have listened it, you will be able to know the definition of macrocytic anemia, its etiologies, megaloblastic anemia, non-megaloproliferative anemia, megaloblastic anemia, and non-megaloblastic anemias. Then you will decide which investigations should be undertaken first. You will have to set a priority depending upon the symptomatology of the patients. And after having diagnosed the patient, you will decide the treatment, of course, with discussing yourself and with your colleagues as to which treatment should be offered. Definition of the anemia, of the macrocytic anemia, is macrocytosis is defined as that the mean corpuscular volume should be greater than 96 femtoliter. It is very common, often due to alcohol abuse without any accompanying anemia. Out of these macrocytic anemias, 5% of the cases are due to vitamin B12 deficiency, and pernicious anemia is one of the common of the macrocytic anemias in the Western countries, but not in the our part of the region. And B12 and folate deficiency are the classical megaloblastic anemias. The megaloblast is a cell in which, when the development of the RBC is going on, the nucleus maturation is delayed compared to the cytoplasm, and there is a disproportionate maturation leading on to the larger cytoplasm and smaller nucleus. This occurs with vitamin B12 and folate deficiency, as they are both needed for the thymidine and DNA synthesis for the nucleus. The etiologies of the megaloblastic anemias are vitamin B12 deficiency, folate deficiency, and cytotoxic drugs. The non-megaloblastic anemias are commonly in the Western, as I said earlier. Alcohol is the most common etiology, then reticulocytosis, especially in hemolysis, and the liver disorders, and other etiologies like hypothyroidism and pregnancy, over-demanding states physiologically, are also the causes of the non-megaloblastic anemias. The other hematological diseases like myelodysplasia, aplastic anemia, multiple myeloma, and myeloproliferative disorders, they also cause macrocytic anemias. Investigations: B12 and folate deficiency result in similar blood film and bone marrow biopsy appearances. In the blood film, there will be hypersegmentation of the polymorphs in B12 and folate deficiency, and the target cells should be found and are found in the liver disorders. Other investigations which are usually undertaken, they include LFTs, thyroid function tests, serum B12 and folate levels, and red cell folate level is a better test, more reliable, and it is a more reliable indicator of the folate status, as the serum folate will reflect that the patient might have taken the folate a few days back or recently. So red cell folate is a better diagnostic tool for the deficiency of the folate. Bone marrow biopsy, it is indicated if the cause is not diagnosed by the above investigations. It is likely to show one of the following four situations or states: the megaloblastic, the picture may be found on bone marrow biopsy, normoblastic marrow may be found, and similarly abnormal erythropoiesis and increased erythropoiesis can also be a possibility in the bone marrow biopsy. Now, first of all, the folate. It is found in green vegetable, nuts, yeast and the liver. It is synthesized by the gut bacteria also, and the body stores will last for 3 to 4 months. So its deficiency relatively occurs very early. Maternal folate deficiency may cause neural tube defects in the fetus. It is absorbed by the duodenum and proximal jejunum. Etiology of the deficiency includes poor diet, that is poverty, alcohol, elderly people, and the increased demand states like pregnancy and hematological malignancies where there is more cell turnover, and similarly the inflammatory diseases and renal dialysis. In the renal dialysis, the dialysate binds the folate and causes the deficiency of the folate. The malabsorption state like non-tropical screw or celiac disease and tropical screw are one of the common causes of the folate deficiency. The drugs which commonly cause deficiency of the folate, they are alcohol, repeatedly spoken, and other drugs include anti-epileptics, commonly used in our society. And the drugs, the anti-epileptic ones include phenytoin and sodium valproate or epivol. Similarly, anti-cancerous drugs like methotrexate and antibiotic trimethoprim are also the culprits in the etiology of the folate deficiency. The treatment, first of all, you should diagnose it or assess it, and you should find out the underlying etiology, that is the poor diet and malabsorption. Then treat with the folic acid. Only you should offer the only required thing is that should you can offer it the oral tablet in the form of 5 mg, the dose of 5 mg per day, and at least for the 4 months. But never use it without vitamin B12, because it is also needed for the maturation of the RBCs. Until or unless the patient is suffering from the subacute combined degeneration of the spinal cord, because in that case you have to check as to what extent the vitamin B12 should be offered. In the pregnancy, the prophylactic doses of the folate, 400 microgram per day, it is started from day 1 and it should be continued till the completion of the first trimester of the pregnancy. That helps the prevention of the spina bifida, and also the anemia is prevented. In all patients with megaloblastic anemia with congestive cardiac failure, with congestive cardiac failure, it is necessary to treat before the results of the B12 and folate are available. I mean, don't wait for the result of the vitamin B12 and folate. Start the treatment and do test, and then treat with the larger doses. Hydroxycobalamin is given in the dose of 1 mg 24 hourly intramuscularly, along with folic acid 5 mg per 24 hours. Blood transfusions are rarely needed in this situation when the patient is suffering from the folate deficiency, as well as simultaneously he is harboring the disease congestive cardiac failure. Folate and ischemic heart disease relationship. It has been observed many a times that the high homocysteine concentrations are associated with a greater risk of coronary heart disease or ischemic heart disease, and it has been suggested or postulated that folic acid supplementation does have a role in the prevention of the cardiac disease by decreasing the homocysteine levels in the circulation. However, the trials have not been very good, rather they have been partly disappointing. B12 deficiency and pernicious anemia, the second part. The vitamin B12 is found in meat and dairy products, but never in the plants. So that is why the vegans or vegetarian people they are likely to develop vitamin B12 and B12 deficiency very easily. Body stores. They are available in the liver for up to 4 years, even in the setting of the liver diseases. Now, mind you, that the stores of the folate stay only are available only for 3 to 4 months, and now the stores of the compare with the B12, that the stores can last for up to 4 years. It is a protein bounded vitamin, and usually the R binder binds it in the stomach, and it is released during digestion as the vitamin B12 passes on from stomach into the terminal ileum. B12 then binds to the intrinsic factor at the later part of the upper part of the intestine, and then this complex is absorbed finally in the terminal ileum. Because the R binder is detached by the pancreatic enzymes, then it becomes free. Actually, the R binder, the protein, protects it from the destruction, but when it reaches the terminal ileum, it is finally absorbed from the terminal ileum. In vitamin B12 deficiency, synthesis of thymidine and DNA is impaired, so red cell production is remarkably reduced. Etiologies of deficiency. Dietary cause is one of the commonest. As I said earlier, that the vegans or vegetarians, they develop the deficiency very early. The malabsorptive states, like starting from the stomach to the terminal ileum, the causes in the stomach include deficiency of the intrinsic factor because of the pernicious anemia, post gastrectomy, then the terminal ileal diseases, ileal resection, Crohn's disease, bacterial overgrowth, tropical sprue, and the tapeworm infestations, that is the diphyllobothrium latum. The congenital abnormalities in the metabolism, they also result in the deficiency of the vitamin B12 features. General features, symptoms of anemia will be found like fatigue, exertional dyspnea, and the patient will become short of breath very early on mild exertion, and if the anemia is more, sometimes the anemia may be very marked and the patient will become short of breath at rest also, having the hyperdynamic circulation also. When you physically examine, the patient may have a lemon tinge to the skin because of the combined presence of the anemia as well as the jaundice because of the hemolysis underlying. Now, when you examine the tongue of the patient, you will be finding glossitis, and classically the beefy red sore tongue is found in cases of vitamin B12 deficiency patients. And similarly, the patient may have angular keloids or keloids. Now, neuropsychiatric problems are also commonly found even in the absence of the anemia, and the mnemonic stands for them is IDUP, that is irritability, depression, dementia, and psychosis. Subacute combined degeneration of the cord, spinal cord, is a very important presentation, and many a times it can be found without the presence of the anemia. The patient to you will be presenting with neuropathy, and he may present to you with spastic paraplegia, and at first glance when you examine the patient, he will be found by your good self as to be having a difficulty in reaching you or walking. So it is because of the symmetrical posterior column loss causing sensory and lower motor neurosigns, and symmetrical corticospinal tract losses or damages causing motor and upper motor neuron sign. Because of the posterior column damage, the patient will be suffering from joint position sense and vibration sense, and they often leads to the ataxia followed by stiffness and weakness if untreated. The classical triad found is extensor or upgoing plantars, absent ankle jerks, and absent sneezes, and it can present with falls at night due to a combination of the ataxia and reduction in the vision, which is also seen with B12 deficiency. Pain and temperature modalities, they do survive as the spinothalamic tracts are preserved. Neurological signs with B12 deficiency can occur without anemia, already discussed. Now, pernicious anemia. This is caused by autoimmune atrophic gastritis leading to deficiency of the hydrochloric acid or achlorhydria, and thereby the lack of the intrinsic factor secretion will result in pernicious anemia. Incidence is usually found in people who are greater than 40 years of age, and higher incidence is common in those people who have a blood group A. The other autoimmune disorders which have association with the pernicious anemia, they are thyroid disease, vitiligo, hypothyroidism, hypoparathyroidism, Addison disease, and one important feature or point to be noted is that the carcinoma of the stomach or CA stomach is threefold more common in patients with pernicious anemia. So the patient will have a low threshold for upper GI endoscopy, which means that if you have diagnosed the patient as a case of pernicious anemia, you must do the upper GI endoscopy at an earlier stage. Other investigations we have usually done, which they include when you do the CBC, hemoglobin may be as low as 3 gram per deciliter and may be up to 11 gram per deciliter. MCB of course is always high, WBC and platelets, they may be low in these cases, and vitamin B12 level is likely to be low. Reticulocytes are low or normal as production is impaired. There may be hypersegmented neutrophils, and when you check the bone marrow, you may find megaloblasts in the marrow. The other specific tests peculiar to the pernicious anemia, they are pruritus cell antibodies. They are found in 90% of the patients of the pernicious anemia, but they are also found in other patients which don't have pernicious anemia and they have other diseases, and their percentage is about 3 to 10%. So this is the weaker aspect of the pruritus cell antibodies test. The other test is intrinsic factor antibodies. They are specific for the pernicious anemia, but their sensitivity is low. These target B12 binding sites in 50% and IL-2 binding sites in 35% of the cases. So that is why these antibodies tests are not very reliable tests, and you have to take the other tests which we will be discussing later on. Now this is the test. Schilling test is done if the parietal cell and the intrinsic factor antibodies are unhelpful. The Schilling test determines that whether the underlying lesion is in the terminal ileum or the lack of the intrinsic factor is the underlying cause in the causation of the vitamin B12 deficiency because of the pernicious anemia. In this test, the oral dose of 1 microgram, which is radio labeled, is given, and it is preceded by the 1 milligram injection of vitamin B12 beforehand. Then you find the excretion of the radio labeled or radioactive vitamin B12 in the urine. If it is dissected and detected in the urine, it means there is no vitamin B12 deficiency. Then you proceed on to the second step, and you offer the patient to the intrinsic factor 60 milligram orally, and then you check the excretion of the vitamin B12, of course the radio labeled in the urine. If it is corrected with the intrinsic factor, then intrinsic factor is the underlying etiology. Similarly, if it is not corrected with the oral administration of the intrinsic factor, then you proceed on to the next step, and that is We offer the patient the pancreatic enzymes. If the excretion of the radio-labeled vitamin B12 is increased or found or detected in the urine, then the pancreatic etiology is the cause of the vitamin B12 deficiency. If it is not corrected or not found in the urine, then you offer a 2-week course of antibiotics, especially the tetracyclines, for detection of the malabsorption as the underlying cause. And again you check after having given a course of 2 weeks of antibiotics the excretion of the radio labeled vitamin B12 in the urine. If it is found or detected in the urine, then malabsorption or bacterial overgrowth is the underlying etiology in the causation of the vitamin B12 deficiency. Now this is the other test which has superseded the Schilling test. Now the algorithm for this test is that you start when you see that the patient's MCV is greater than 100 femtoliter, then you proceed further. Do the peripheral smear, check the vitamin B12 and also check the reticulocyte count. If the reticulocyte count is more than 2%, the job becomes easier. The underlying cause is hemolytic anemia. Forget about the hemolytic anemia. Then you check the megaloblastic features. And in those cases, the reticulocyte count must be less than 2%. Then you check the level of the vitamin B12 in the circulation. It may have three forms. The level may be less than 100, it may be between 100 and 400, and it may be greater than 400. If the level is less than 100, of course the vitamin B12 will be less than 100, straight away it is a vitamin B12 deficiency. You need not be doing anything more. If the level is between 100 to 400, then get the levels of the MMA, methyl malonic acid, in the serum, and similarly the homocysteine levels in the circulation. Now it may have three forms. If the MMA and homocysteine levels are checked and homocysteine level is very high and vitamin B12 level is less than 100, then it is a B12 deficiency. Remember that the MMA and homocysteine level will be very high. I repeat, the methyl malonic acid and homocysteine level both will be raised. If the level of vitamin B12 is less than 100, so the diagnosis will be straight away vitamin B12 deficiency. If the methyl malonic acid and homocysteine levels are absolutely normal, then you will have to proceed to the bone marrow biopsy in the range of vitamin B12 level 100 to 400. And if the methyl malonic acid level is low but homocysteine is high, I repeat again, if the methyl malonic acid level is low and homocysteine level is high, the diagnosis will be folate deficiency. And contrarily, if the homocysteine level is low and methyl malonic acid is high, the diagnosis will be vitamin B12 deficiency. Now finally, if the B12 level is greater than 400, then do the RBC folate levels. I repeat again, if the B12 level is greater than 400, check the RBC folate level. It is a more reliable test. If it is normal, you will have to proceed to the straight way to the bone marrow biopsy. If it is low, the job becomes easier. It is a folate deficiency. This test is more reliable and very beautiful. Remember it. It has replaced the Schilling test. Now treatment. Treat the cause if possible. Most causes are due to malabsorption, so injections are required. Replenish stores with hydroxycobalamin 1 mg intramuscular on alternate days for 2 weeks. Or if the CNS signs, they stop improvement. Keep remembering that if there is, in other words, that if there is no improvement of the CNS signs, stop giving the B12 further. Then the maintenance dose is given 1 milligram every 3 months for life. If the cause is dietary, then oral B12 can be given after the initial acute course. Initial improvement is heralded, the news is broken by the initial treatment in the form, by the way, that there will be transient reticulocytes in the circulation which have a high MCV after 4 to 5 days of therapy. So if you find reticulocyte after a week, so it means your treatment is successful. Practical hints: beware of diagnostic pernicious anemia in those who are under 40 years of age, and look for GI malabsorption, the small bowel disease or biopsy will be required. Watch for hypokalemia as treatment is going on. Now, transfusion is best avoided, but with pernicious anemia, the exchange transfusion is usually performed. After doing tests for full blood count, folate, vitamin B12, and marrow sampling. As hemoptysis accelerates on treatment, additional iron must be given. Iron must be given along with the B12. Hemoglobin rises by 1 gram per deciliter per week. WBC and platelets should normalize in 1 week. Prognosis: supplementation usually improves peripheral neuropathy within 1 to 3 months. It takes a little time, but has little effect on cord signs. Cord signs are never improved. Patients do best if treated as soon as possible after the onset of the symptoms. Do not delay. The caution is there. Now, MCQ: a 65-year-old vegetarian or vegan has presented with gradually worsening asthenia from a few weeks. He becomes short of breath after minimal exertion. On examination, there is failure of the conjunctiva and rest of the examination is normal. Lab results show Hb less 7 gram per deciliter with macrocytosis and hypersegmented WBCs on peripheral smear. What is the most probable cause of anemia? This is a MCQ for you. The answer lies in one of these. Choose the best of one. Another MCQ: a 40-year-old female complains of progressive weakness and excessive dyspnea from 1.5 months. There is also complaint of numbness of feet and difficulty walking over uneven surfaces. On examination, there is failure of the conjunctiva, mild icterus, and sore tongue with angular stomatitis. Classical features: examination of the nervous system reveals impaired joint position and vibration sense over feet and depressed ankle joints. Plantar response is normal. What is the most appropriate investigation to reach the diagnosis? So one of, again, the best of these five options is the answer, and very easy looking MCQ. These are the clinical features. You see, it is a red beefy tongue which is found in the vitamin B12 deficiency. This is, the patient is having peripheral neuropathy. The peripheral neuropathy presents insidiously. It is a beguiling but harmful presentation. The patient early part enjoys the tingling and pricking sensation, but later on it becomes very painful. So sensory neuropathy then becomes harmful. Early part, it is seductive. Now, the patient may have a diffuse hair loss. Remember that the hair loss, gradual hair loss, is also a feature of the vitamin B12 deficiency. Now, folate deficiency leads to the, if not started from the start of the pregnancy to till the completion of the first term or first trimester, the patient may have anencephaly, which means that the patient's brain is absent or it is poorly developed. And this, similarly, the patient may have spina bifida, which means the spinal cord and the spine, they do not unite accurately, leading on to the spinal bifidal defect. Now, the patient may have ulcers on the lip, We commonly dub them as or label them as the abscess ulcers, but one should also take into consideration that the patient might not be a case of vitamin B12 deficiency. Now, when the posterior column losses are there because of the in the subacute combined degeneration, as part of the subacute combined degeneration of the cord, the posterior column loss will lead to the sign known as Romberg sign. The patient usually they fall on the nights, and when the eyes of the patient are closed with approximation of the patient approximation of the feet, the patient will tend to fall on the ipsilateral side, I mean the affected side of the dorsal columns. Now on endoscopy, this patient is having atrophic gastritis. So as I said earlier, that the endoscopy should be performed earlier. One should not wait. If you have diagnosed the patient as pernicious anemia, its endoscopy should be done earlier, because the incidence of carcinoma is threefold increased, and in addition you can pick the atrophic gastritis early, and the diagnosis become early to be established. Now this is the peripheral film. You see there are megaloblasts, and you also can see the segmentation of the neutrophil is more, meaning thereby the patients are classically having peripheral blood film, popularly known as that there is megaloblast formation and there is hyper segmentation of the polymorphs. This is again the same feature. One cell is shown, comparison is made between a normal cell. You see the size of the red cell is shorter, and see the segmentation of the nucleus, and there are few segments only. And here in the WBC there are about 5-6 segments, and similarly the size of the RBC is much, MCV is much higher compared to the normal RBC size. Any question, you will be most welcome. And before I pay thanks to you, I will like to have the feedback. Any questions you can ask me. Last time you did not answer anything, you did not give any feedback, you did not solve the assignment. My mission is that the online teaching should be as best as possible, and it is not a difficult thing. As we are enjoying the online teaching, we are day by day improving, and personally it is very lucrative for me, and it is a wonder word if I keep on doing the online teaching to the people at large. Okay, thank you very much. I'll be waiting for your feedback. It is goodbye from Akhtar Sahib Trust Hospital.